with Thomas Nador this morning from Buru Energy. Thomas, good to see you. Good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Look, certainly been busy from you as from a news perspective over the last 7 days. You've had three announcements out. Just give us firstly a bit of an overview as to what some of these updates have involved.
Well, we continue to build the momentum of our Rafael development through good execution discipline. All the focus since the discovery of Rafael has been on de-risking the development, and in doing so, creating the best possible conditions for third parties to join us in commercializing this world-class resource. Over the past week, we have announced that we have successfully completed the 3D seismic survey over the Rafael structure. We have selected an advisor to assist us in ensuring that we get the right development partner to come on a journey with us. And we have kicked off a pre-FEED engineering study to ensure we maintain schedule to early cash flows for a phase one base development that is supported by an already defined low volume estimate of the Rafael contingent resource. So the pieces are certainly falling into place, Andrew.
Well, Thomas, just firstly on that 3D seismic, just tell us a bit more about the significance of this work and how it fits in with the wider plans.
The Rafael structure was discovered on very sparse 2D seismic, so the value of this 3D seismic survey cannot be overstated. The data acquired will be used to further define the extent of the Rafael structure, thereby improving resource definition, and will also assist us in planning for a 2024 appraisal drilling program. The survey included several 2D lines into an adjacent permit to the south, which will help us define additional prospects that we have identified previously, which may be really beneficial for a backfill for a Rafael development. Completing the survey on time and on budget, with the lion's share of the cost borne by Origin as part of the deal we struck with them when they exited the permits, will be very helpful for potential third parties looking at co-developing the field with us.
Thomas, why have you decided to appoint an advisor at this stage, given the partner selection process has been going on for some time?
Look, we are definitely not starting from scratch, and the timing of Miro Capital's appointment is not coincidental. Over the past several months, I've been receiving valuable feedback from potential development partners as to what they are looking for before they commit to participating in this partner selection process. This includes the availability of 3D seismic data, the completion of commercialization studies that cover the full range of Rafael contingent resources, and doing everything we can to maintain a realistic schedule to first gas for development, including our plans to appraise the resource next year. I'm pleased to say that we are delivering on these points and more, and we are now in the best possible position to attract credible interest for Rafael and our prospective Canning Basin permits that are well placed to provide upside to development. Hence, we believe this is the right time to get the process formally kicked off with the help of Miro Capital, who will not only run the process for us, but introduce parties invisible to us to participate in the Rafael development.
And of course, the award of the pre-FEED study, that was a big one for Rafael phase one. Tell us a little bit more about this.
Thank you, Andrew. Look, GHD is a global professional services company who will deliver pre-FEED level engineering for the phase one development. As noted before, phase one is based on the already defined low contingent resource volume for Rafael and consists of a small footprint hybrid gas to power and renewables project. It's not a boilerplate oil and gas project, and we are dealing with molecules as well as electrons. So GHD's expertise and innovation will be a key ingredient in delivering the pre-FEED scoop. We expect the work will allow the progression into FEED in the second half of next year, with final investment decision in 2025 and first production for this phase one development in 2027. So in addition to providing early cash flows in 2027, this domestic focused project with a substantively reduced carbon footprint compared to existing supply arrangements will be an enabler for a potentially large Rafael development involving blue ammonia, methanol, or LNG that will be informed by our planned appraisal next year. So we certainly have a lot going on, Andrew.
Hey, good to see you. Thanks, Thomas.
Thank you so much.